Hello, this is the Lego Ninjago movie Shark Attack set, and it's in the juniors line, so very low parts count for the amount of stuff that you get here. They use a unitary car chassis piece for the shark car over on the right. No stickers, everything is printed, which is pretty cool, kind of deluxe, but it still has over 100 pieces, so there's definitely some stuff that you do. The shark car is based on one of the standard juniors car platforms, but they've built it up decently well. That's a really nice large printed piece on the front. It's actually pretty cool. That is, I believe, useful for some other custom builds at some point. They've done a nice job of extending out the sides from this large one piece, ultimately chassis preformed, to allow some things to attach there to give you some fins there. They have the large fin at the back. And what are these? Well, these are, what are those? Those are flip fire missiles. So, whoo, that was good. Get this one up, oh, almost. A little bit weaker, but yeah, those fire off. So you can actually shoot something from here. And this is not intended to be really part of the vehicle. That's a little bit unfortunate there that it is at this strange angle. I wish they had angled the clip piece 90 degrees off, because this is the weapon for the figure there. Would have been nicer if it attached just like this. I think these are supposed to represent floats back here, or possibly water propulsion units. These are printed pieces here on the sides, which are actually new with the number 4 on them. So they didn't even reuse the old printed 1x4 kind of caution stripe pieces. They could have, but instead they added this anew. And I believe this is the cheapest set that will allow you to get this new printed piece here, this printed console, which is specific to the Lego Ninjago movie. It says Seek over on the left-hand side. I don't know what the other symbols are supposed to represent. There are some letters and numbers as best I can tell, but it doesn't seem to make any sense. But there's a bunch of printed pieces on such a small set, so I like that. Every fan of Ninjago knows that Kai is a fan of motorcycles, and this is an exclusive printed motorcycle fairing piece. So it has that print on the front of it. It's too bad it didn't get any decoration on the sides. I mean, this looks really cool from the front, but you turn around to the side, it starts to look a little bit plain to me, especially with the flag that they put back there, you know, especially since it's just rectangular, you know, that kind of takes some of the excitement away from it. I like the flames coming off the back. That's nicely and simply done. And, you know, otherwise it's just a standard modern sport bike that Lego does, you know, nice and low to the ground and everything. And I will show you the figures up close in a couple of minutes. And then here we have some training equipment, which is supposed to be inside of a dojo, possibly inside of the Destiny's Bounty. The nicest thing here to me is the wood breaking stand, because these are 1x3 printed tiles, and you can actually use a sword or a minifig to just come through here and cut right through those. That's pretty cool. They're just attached at either end, and I think it might even be more cool or feel more cool to do that with a figure, you know, just stick out a leg like that or something like that and come down with it. It works really nicely. I would like to have seen more of those, but of course you can use other pieces to create similar things elsewhere. This is just a container that has a couple of gunmetal gray colored size, so you can use those as alternate weapons to train with. Comes with this one single sword, which is actually Lloyd's signature sword, Chinese style, with the golden tassel at the base of it. But over here on the wall is a clip where you can place that instead, and you can switch over to a black katana. This is a spinning training dummy sort of element, so you can use your figures with that to hit it and, you know, practice ducking and attacking. Striking has the spikes going around the center. I believe that was originally brought out in Nexo Knights with some funky colors, but here it's in just a plain reddish brown, which is a useful color. And speaking of new pieces, that is the first of this piece that I personally have gotten my hands on, gotten to see in person. You will see lots and lots of that piece in the Ninjago City set, which I will review once it is released so that I can actually buy it. Can't buy it until it's released, but that's I think mostly Japanese inspired, Japanese architecture inspired. A little bit general, but a really cool piece that will create a repeating pattern. You can see half of a square on the left, half a square on the right. When you put multiple of those together, it just continues with kind of a chain of those squares. I like all of the banister style pieces that LEGO makes, and the more different designs they make, the happier I am. So here are the figures up close with Lloyd on the left, Kai in the middle, and a great white on the right with his fish harpoon weapon. Now, this is on the left is a spinjitzu training version of Lloyd, but all the spinjitzu training gi are the same. The torso, the printed hip piece, and the legs, those are the same from one to the next. So I'm a little bit hesitant to call out, you know, exclusive version when this is a headpiece that is used on others, and then the you know, actual clothing pieces, all the body pieces are used on others as well. But looks good, nice to get just by itself. If you don't have, you know, a spare head from something else that you don't want to use, it's good to be able to get the entire figure all together. Just make a little space for these guys. There we go. Looks at them from the back with all their gear on. Alternate faces for both the ninja, but not for the great white. Sorry, dude. Yeah, you're not special enough. And there are the full views of the faces from the front. So a pretty good set for juniors with a lot of nice printed pieces that we probably won't see anywhere else. And you get that version of Lloyd as well. I personally definitely would have preferred more of the board break segments to this. Could have taken off maybe the back half of this wall, left out, or used that piece there as part of another board break. I could have done without this. Just the board break is so fun. Definitely, to me, the most fun thing in this entire set. They need to do more things like that. Make better use of the fact that LEGO comes apart. I think they need to do stuff like that more frequently in sets, just in general, as an action feature. But there you go. That's my look at this set, and I think that overall it's pretty good. Hope that you enjoyed this quick look at this small set, and I hope that you will come back to check out more of my reviews and other videos, because more are on the way. Speaking of which, I'm going to continue working, so I'll be talking to you again very soon.